Hi, I'm Colin Smith from Photoshop Cafe, and welcome to part 3 of a 3-part series on editing drone videos inside of Adobe Premiere Pro CC. So in the first clip, I was able to take the footage off the micro SD card on the drone and then upload it to the Seagate DJI Fly Drive because it has a built-in micro SD card reader. So I was able to put that card in there, upload the footage, and then do a rough assembly inside of Adobe Premiere Pro CC on location. In part 2, I show some other effects, how to do speed ramping, how to smoothen out your shots, and how to recompose 4K footage into a 1080 timeline. In this video, I'm gonna show you 3 really exciting things. So the first thing I'm gonna show is how to add music to your timeline. Then I'm gonna show you how to add a cinematic color grade. And then finally, I'm going to show how to finish this up with some titling. If you don't have Premiere Pro, it comes bundled for free with the Seagate DJI Fly Drive. You get 2 months of Premiere Pro CC. So now we're going to add music to the video track. And choosing the music is really important to find something that really fits the flavor and mood of what you want to work with. So I've made a folder here with music. And if you hold the Control or Command on Mac, double click, and we can open that folder within the window. And it's really simple. All we're going to do is just grab the track we want and then just click and drag it down to the audio, and it adds it into the file. Now, usually you'll find that if you play, it's going to be too loud. As you can see there, it's clipping. All you need to do is just hit the G key, and that brings up the audio gain. And I'm going to set this to -2, hit OK. And now you've got your levels where they're not clipping, and you can just simply click and drag here to make them louder or quieter. All right, so let's move on to another thing now. Let's have a look at cinematic color grading. Okay, so we've got this clip here, and I have applied a Lumetri color to it already. See, that's before and after, so we've done some adjustments there. And we can make this even more cinematic. What we can do is we're gonna choose the color, and it's gonna open up our Lumetri panel here. So we've got our basic adjustments and everything is looking pretty good. And if we click and drag down, we can kind of see that better. So one of the things you'll find in very cinematic looking footage, you know, watch TV, watch movies, and kind of get a feel for how they look. And a lot of the time you'll see they'll be crushing the blacks, and it adds a sense of strength, mystery, and drama to the clip. Now we've got these built-in presets. If we look up here, you can see basic correction, input LUTs. The LUTs are also available under Creative. And what is a LUT? A LUT is just basically a preset, and Premiere Pro comes with a bunch. So if we click here under the look, you can see we've got a lot of different types here. You know, we could click on maybe this Fuji one to see the effect, and notice immediately it gives it a very cinematic effect. I'm just going to hit Control Z to undo it, because what we can do is actually go in this window here and we can click through and we can get a feel for these different LUTs. So all we've got to do now is just click through until we find one that we like. Maybe this one, and to apply it, we simply click. And notice how it gives it that very rich look right there. Now we can adjust the intensity of that, as if we reduce the intensity down, that's without the LUT, and then we pull it all the way up, we can really push that. So I encourage you to experiment with the different LUTs, a very quick way to make your footage look cinematic. All right, let's add a title so we can identify this clip. So let's go near the beginning of the clip here. We're just gonna move up to a good spot, would be about here. And I'm just clicking and dragging from the corner there to reposition these windows a little bit so I can get my main monitor nice and big so we can add our titling. Now to do titles, it's as simple as grabbing the type tool and then just clicking now, and we can add our title. And there we go, we have a title there. So let me move that around. Now, if you want to change this or you want to style it, you can simply open up this panel under the window, go down to Essential Graphics, and choose Edit. And now you can change any of this information. We can change the color there. We can hide that stroke if we want, or we could maybe change it to a black stroke. And you can change the thickness of it by dragging there, see that? and then we can see our title there. Now, if this is a little hard to read, we can put a background behind it. So what we're going to do is we're going to click the little new layer, and we're going to create a rectangle. And let's set the color of it to maybe a darker gray. And now we just simply click it and drag it to where we want it to go. And we can resize it just by clicking on those little handles. Now you might have noticed this is in front and it needs to be behind. Just simply go up here and we can drag it underneath the text. And there we go. It's that easy to add a title inside of Premiere Pro. Now, if you want this to fade in rather than come in like that, just select it and hit Control D, and that will apply a default dissolve. And we can just play it now. See how now it nicely fades in, and it nicely fades out. So when you've finished all your editing and you want to get it out of Premiere into a video, you just simply choose File, Export, and then choose Export to Media. And then the window will come up and you can choose a preset. In this case, I'm going to choose YouTube 1080. Then you could just go down and hit the export and this will render into this a video that you can share. So I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.